we now discuss the solution of a problem that appeared in the Joint Entrance Examination Main held on 27th June 2022 in the second shift. The given problem is related to the solution of a given linear differential equation. And this question is from the section Differential Equations. The given question is, if the solution curve of the differential equation in brackets tan inverse y minus x into dy is equal to in brackets 1 plus y square into dx passes through the point 1, 0, then the abscissa of the point on the curve whose ordinate is tan 1 is, we are given four options: option A 2e, option B 2/e, option C 2, option D 1/e. We are given a differential equation, that is tan inverse y minus x in brackets dy is equal to 1 plus y square in brackets dx. And given the solution curve of this differential equation passes through the point 1, 0, then required to find the abscissa, means the x coordinate of the point on the curve whose ordinate, that is whose y is tan y. That means find x when y is equal to tan 1. So that is the question. That is the given question to us. Let's now discuss the solution of the problem in detail. This is our given differential equation. This can be written as 1 plus y square into dx by dy is equal to tan inverse y minus x. Now bring this minus x from right hand side to left hand side. It becomes plus x and divide throughout by 1 plus y square. Then this becomes dx by dy plus 1 by 1 plus y square into x is equal to tan inverse y by 1 plus y square. So this differential equation is of the form dx by dy plus p of y, p a function of y into x is equal to q a function of y. What is it? It is a first order linear differential equation in x. To solve such a differential equation, we find its integrating factor. IF stands for integrating factor, and it is given by e power integral p of y dy. Now in our case, p of y is 1 by 1 plus y square, q of y is tan inverse y by 1 plus y square. Now after finding the integrating factor, we write down its general solution, and it is given by x into the integrating factor is equal to integral of q of y, that is the right hand side function, multiplied by the integrating factor, integrate with respect to y, plus c, where c is an arbitrary constant. Now in our case, the integrating factor is e power integral p of y dy. P of y is 1 by 1 plus y square. So this is e power integral 1 by 1 plus y square dy, and this integral is tan inverse y. So this will be e power tan inverse y. Now the general solution we will write down. Now x into integrating factor e power tan inverse y is equal to integral of q of y. Q of y is tan inverse y by 1 plus y square into the integrating factor, that is e power tan inverse y. then with integrate with respect to y plus c, where c is a constant of integration, which is an arbitrary constant to be evaluated. Right. Now, how do we integrate this? That we will show you in this snippet. So, for this, put tan inverse y is equal to t, differentiating, you will get 1 by 1 plus y square dy is equal to dt. So, put tan inverse y is equal to t, differentiating both sides, 1 by 1 plus y square dy is equal to dt. Then the integral now becomes 1 by 1 plus y square dy will be dt, and tan inverse y is t into e power t. So the integral t e power t dt. Now this is a standard integral whose integral is known to us. It's a known integral. Right. So we do it by the integration by parts, and we get t minus 1 in brackets into e power t, and replace t by tan inverse y, then we will get tan inverse y minus 1 in brackets multiplied by e power tan inverse y. That is the integral of that. Let's go back to our mainstream. This is equal to, after the integration, it will be tan inverse y minus 1 into e power tan inverse y plus c. Thus we get the general solution as x into e power tan inverse y is equal to tan inverse y minus 1 in brackets into e power tan inverse y plus c. We continue in the next slide. We have the GS, right? Now what is this one? It's a relationship between x and y, and it gives rise to a curve. As c is an arbitrary constant, it will give rise to a family of curves. But each relation is a solution of the differential equation. So you get a family of the solution curves of the given differential equation when c is an arbitrary constant. From this family, find out that curve, that solution curve, which passes through 1, 0. That means if you put x is equal to 1, y is equal to 0, then c will be evaluated, and that, for that value of c, this will give rise to the solution curve of the differential equation. So given the solution curve passes through 1, 0, so you put x is equal to 1, y is equal to 0 in the above general solution, we get x is 1 into e power tan inverse 0, wherever there is y, you write 0, in brackets tan inverse 0 minus 1 into e power tan inverse 0 plus c. Now, tan inverse 0 is 0, e power 0 is 1, tan inverse 0 is 0 minus 1 into e power tan inverse 0 is 1 plus c. So that is 1 is equal to 0 minus 1 minus 1 plus c. So c will be equal to 2. So substituting the value of c in the GS, then you will get the solution curve of the differential equation, what the question is talking about. So this is the solution curve. Now, what is to be found? So you find the abscissa, means x coordinate, of the point on the curve whose ordinate is tan 1, that is whose y is tan 1. That means find x when y is equal to tan 1. So required to find x when y is equal to tan 1. So that means to put y is equal to tan 1 in the above particular solution and solve for x, then you will get the abscissa what is required in the question. So put, so x into, wherever there is y, you write tan 1, e power tan inverse of y means tan 1 is equal to tan inverse of y means tan 1 minus 1 into e power tan inverse of tan 1 plus 2. So tan inverse of tan 1 is 1. So e power 1 will be e, x into e is equal to, this is 1 minus 1, 0. 1 minus 1 is 0. So plus 2, that means you will get x into e is equal to 2. Therefore, the abscissa, the x coordinate, when y is tan 1 is given by x is equal to 2 by e. That is your answer. Let's look at our options. Our answer 2 by e appears against option B. Therefore, the answer to this question is option B. So that is the detailed discussion of the solution of a problem which is related to the solution of a given linear differential equation from the section Differential Equations. I am sure that you have understood the solution of this problem, and I wish you all the best. Thank you.